then you tell someone, you talk to someone about it, and they're like, well, why didn't you report it? Well, like, I'm sorry, but I'm going through a lot, and I just wanted it to go away. So there's a lot of reasons, and I don't think anyone's going to understand why you didn't report it to the police. One, I was younger, and I didn't know what would happen. Like, I actually don't even know what... I didn't know what a police report would even do. Now I do, and now that I know I can press charges. But that time, I was like, what is that going to do? How... Do I have to get my parents involved? Like...
Yeah.
You know, it's all... It's sad.
When you say young, just before some people's trying to say that you was young, young, how old was you at the time?
I think... Okay, I'm... So, 23.
You were 23 at the time?
Yes.
Okay, that's fine. I just had to say that because when you were saying young, I don't want people to start thinking that there's some 15-year-old girl in the room.
Yeah, no. I was 20, and, you know, I have to think every decision I make, like, I have to make sure, you know, I don't embarrass my family, embarrassing. That is an embarrassment on your parent.
Of course it is.
This is why a lot of people don't go to the police.
Yeah.
So,
Okay. Is there anything else you want me to, before we close this off?
I honestly, can I say something to people watching?
Of course you can, yeah, go for it. Do you want me to turn this around, or are you okay?
Oh, I'm not seen, right?
You can't be seen, no.
Right, okay.
Okay.
I want men to understand that if you're with a woman and she says no one time, then just stop. Stop whatever you're doing one time, just stop. If she's uncomfortable, stop what you're doing. And let alone 100 times you say no. But just if she says no once, just stop. And women, just don't blame yourself if you're in a situation like that. Like if you're drunk and
if she says no once, just
someone's being forceful and force you into doing something, don't blame yourself because you did not ask to be raped. You did not ask for him to force himself on you. Don't blame yourself. That's all. That's all I'm going to say.
Okay. Again, look, you know, I admire your bravery for coming on and, you know, I respect it. And hopefully, you know, people that have watched this, they will actually take note from what you're saying. And if, you know, if people don't want to believe you or for whatever reason, then, you know, that's...
I'm not going to believe me, but that's fine. At least I said my truth.
Of course.
And I tried to warn someone about him.
Yeah.
That I can go to bed happy.
Yeah.
I can go to sleep happy that I tried my best to warn someone.
Okay.
So, you know, I'll be fine if no one believes me.
Yeah.
Because, again, if he even tries to lie, I will just contact the police at this point because everyone in my family knows.
Yeah.
So,
we've got a few things that, I mean, pretty much puts him bang to rights anyway. The text message, I've got the hotel that are now willing to come forward. And obviously I'm there anyway if you need me for anything. I've got the bank statements and stuff to provide. So I don't want to talk too much about the authorities right now because there's already something going on.
Sorry.
What happened?
Sorry, that's my dog. Just one second. Oh. Okay, sorry.
That's all right. But yeah, so like I said, anything you need, let me know, I'm here. And, you know, I'll be in touch with you after December when I close this all off. But listen, thank you so much for coming on. And, you know, whenever, if you're ever in the UK or whatever, hit me up. But yeah, just let me know and we'll take it from there, yeah?
Okay, thank you.
Listen, thanks so much for coming on, all right?
Okay,
you take care of yourself. Bye.
Hello.
Hey, what's going on? You okay?
Hey, yeah, what's up?
Yeah, don't worry, I've got the phone facing up on the I can't see your name. Just quickly, obviously you know that I've put it up and everything. I just wanted to kind of speak to you and see how you felt after now that's out.
That the video's out?
Yeah.
I mean, I really don't know. I mean, I'm kind of in, I don't know. My main thing from the get-go was just to, like, let people be aware of his actions. Like, if they see him out, just be careful. I know he's charming, I know this, that, just be careful.
Yeah.
So, as long as people are being careful, that's what I wanted, you know?
Yeah, no, because obviously I'm reading some of the comments and stuff, and, you know, some of the comments are like, you know, why is she coming after 5 years? Which is kind of the stuff that I kind of told you at the beginning. I said, look, you know, you got to get ready for some of these people, because the problem that you face with these people is...
Why did I now come out and talk about this after 5 years?
Yeah.
I mean, I'm pretty sure didn't we talk about that already? Like...
Yeah, no, I know. I'm just going off the comments because there's some sick, sick motherfuckers on there. And when I say sick, I mean like, you know, if they had a daughter and their daughter was to say this, or their sister was to come and say this after 5 years, they'll be reacting completely different. But the fact that it's Adam Saleh's, someone that's saying it about Adam Saleh saying it, now it's like, oh my God, how dare you say this after 5 years? This is what I mean by the sick people that follow him. And this is what I mean by the... This is why when I told you that day, I said some of the people that follow him, they actually make me sick, like sick to my stomach. Like, oh, now that it's a girl that's talking, but she done it with Adam. Oh, that can't be rape. She was drunk, you know.
And you know, I mean, that's everything that I was scared about. Why I even wanted to speak out. Everything that you just said is why I didn't want to speak out.
Yeah.
But now that, like, and I was younger back then. And
I'm just reading a comment. Someone says, you've got a daughter, and you didn't know about it. I didn't know about it until I spoke to her now. I heard about it back then when Adam told me that she is trying to cry rape on him, but she had already left by then. So the person who just wrote that, You need to start finding out things before you come out here, because we're talking about a rape victim here and you're out here trying to cross-examine her? Come on, bro.
Yeah, actually, so I don't know if I don't know if we went over this in our interview, but after that situation happened, I left right away. Like, I left after, as soon as I could, we left. So... I didn't see you, person B, or...
No, listen, I don't want you to explain yourself to me. You don't need to explain yourself to me, but I'm just reading people on there saying, you know, why did she leave it 5 years? Why are you just talking about it now? Or why you're in on it as well? Like, you know, it's just, it makes me sick at how some of these people speak. Like, this is somebody who's come out after 5 years, who's had the courage to come out and speak after 5 years, and that's your approach? This is the reason why, like, I can't be on this social media shit anymore, because of the amount of vile... If this was their sister that came out after even 10 years, right? It will be a completely different reaction. They'll be looking for the guy.
Yeah.
You know? They'll be trying to kill
the
guy.
I'm sure it's because I'm a random girl that no one knows, that no one, you know, no one knows me, but everyone loves and supports him and has... He's got all these fans that back him, and just because... He's a big, powerful person or whatever. Like, that doesn't take away what he did. So, I mean, I don't know. The main reason why I didn't speak out is because I have a freaking family. I didn't know if my parents had to get involved. Like, I don't want... Back then, I didn't want my parents to find out. That's so embarrassing.
Yeah.
You have to get your parents involved. Like, I don't know what would have come about it, you know? But now that I'm older, I'm like, I realize that, okay, it's not my fault. I didn't do anything other than say no 1,000 times. So it's not my fault. And now that I know that I can press charges, it's like I told you, if he tries to deny what I'm saying, I will go press charges because I still can press charges. Because even though it's 5 years later, I can still press charges and he will be in jail.
Yeah, no, of course. Look, I don't want you to think that I'm trying to cross-examine you or anything like that, because that's not what I'm trying to do. I'm just reading some of these comments, and some of the people that are just sick motherfuckers in this room. Yeah. You know, trying to basically.
Oh God, I'm scared to see that. I'm not even gonna look.
It's all right. It doesn't matter. Listen. It's cut out. Hello.
Hello.
Oh, I just heard myself.
Hello.
No, I thought it cut out. But okay, look, listen, I'll call you later.
Hello?
Can you hear me?
Yeah, I keep connecting to my AirPods, I don't know why. Sorry.
Yeah. No, that's alright. Look, you carry on. I just wanted to kind of see how you felt that now that you've managed to get it out. Because I remember when you spoke... It's cut out again, sorry, I can hear myself.
I don't know why. I'm sorry, can you hear me?
I can hear you now, yeah. I was just saying, like, you know, I just wanted to kind of speak to you and see that now that it's out, because I remember you telling me that, you know what, Naz, I haven't been able to speak about it for 5 years. You're the first person I've spoken to, but now that it's out, I just wanted to see kind of, you know, how you feel about it. You know, if there was anything that you wanted to kind of tell somebody. It's cut out again. Do you want me to call you back?
Yeah, sorry. Just 1 second. Hold on. I can just turn Bluetooth off. 1 second. There we go. Can you hear me now?
Yeah.
It shouldn't cut off. I've disconnected. So.
Apart from some of the scumbags that are on here, to the people that actually give a shit, like, have you got anything to say to them before, you know, some of the girls that are out here? If not, it's not a problem. You don't have to say anything. I completely understand.
Do I want to say anything to who? I'm sorry.
There's a lot of people here supporting you. So obviously, if there's something that you want to tell them about speaking up, if there's other people, because there's a lot of people messaging me now trying to come forward. But.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
That's so sad.
You have to understand his fans. I don't know if someone's just chatting shit to me either. So I got to make sure that, you know, they're not just coming forward just for the sake of it now. Just to kind of, you know, so I mean, my DMs right now are just absolutely mad, just full of people saying, you know, he did this to me. So obviously I don't know which one to take seriously. But again, if there is something that you want to tell people that have kind of, you know, not had the balls to come forward, you know, not had the courage to come forward. And if other people have been through it, if there's anything that you want to tell them, here's your chance, basically.
I think that if you want to take your time after something like this happens to you, and if you've been raped or abused in any way, and you want to take your time and you don't want to go to the police right away, then you should do that, because nothing matters. It's just how you handle it and how your mental health is. So if you need time and you want to, like I did, I brushed it under the rug. I didn't want to talk about it. You know, even my two best friends were there. How I want to handle it is I want to brush it under the rug. I don't want my parents involved. You know, it's embarrassing to my culture or whatever, then I'm going to do that. And if you finally have courage to speak out, and, you know, people are going to support you. People aren't going to believe you. Doesn't matter. As long as you have that off your chest, then at least you will feel better as a person. Like, I feel better speaking about it finally.
Yeah.
Like I told you after that I had an interview with you, it's almost therapeutic, because I didn't talk in depth about it with anyone for that long. Of course, my husband, I did, but just it was
and your husband and everyone, I'm assuming they all know and everything, right?
Of course, yeah. My husband knows. He's great. He's absolutely great.
Yeah,
he would. If you ever saw him, he would probably be in his
I'm just. Patient. I'm just gonna quickly pin somebody right now, because I'm just going to pin this comment. If there's any real people on here, please go and message this guy. What do you mean if a girl went to a hotel room, what does she expect? What do you trying to say. This is what he's trying to say.
That's consent, going back to someone's hotel
this
room?
Is, yeah, this, no, is, this, is, this is what he's trying to say. He's basically saying, why did you go to the hotel room? What did she expect?
And I'm pretty sure I've already said in the interview that, you know, that's not even in our character to do. My best friend came from out of town, and we went out that one weekend. And I don't need to defend, I don't need to defend myself to people that I don't even know, strangers. I'm doing this just so you all, like, watch out for him. You know?